Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming for this weekly meeting of RPI English School. So, can you hear my voice? Oh, no. Well, today we have an interesting topic. We will talk about COVID-19 in health and psychology. But before that, there will be a self-introduction from our members, RPI English course members. And then before that, I want to talk a little bit about RPI English schools. So in RPI English school, we learn English together. So we learn English through WhatsApp group. So we have some assignment to give our comment or our idea about something, and then we type on a WhatsApp group. After that, we record our voice by speaking. So we practice our writing, and our or newcomer who want to join us, you can say, or you can contact our committee later, or you can give your comment on chat. Through our WhatsApp group. So that is the introduction about RPI English schools. So before that, there will be a familiar name. So we go on to the next agenda. Before that, there will be some words by Kak Mahadalena. Can you hear me? Or
she's not here.
Oh, sorry. Okay, so maybe we next to the self introduction. We go to Miss Rupriana Melisa from Cilapat.
Cilacap.
Sorry. Are you here? Cilacap, sorry. Mbak Anna, are you here?
Yes, I'm here. Hello, can you hear my voice?
Okay, Mbak Anna, can you introduce yourself? Yes, we can hear your voice.
I'm first. Oh, so, no.
You'll come late, I think. So, Mbak Anna, is it okay if you are the first?
Oh, okay. Okay. Doesn't matter. Okay. Okay, thank you, Miss. What I should call you, Musdalifah. Musdalifah, thank you, Musdalifah, for this.
Yeah.
Am I right, Musdalifah Mansur?
Yes.
Sorry, the signal is not stable. Firstly, I would like to say thank you for this opportunity, and actually. On the last Monday, Widya asked me to do a self introduction, and I will let you know about me. My name is Supriyana Melisa. You can call me Anna. I come from Cilacap, but my working place in Subang, West Java. I work as civil servant in Indonesian Institute of Sciences. And today, I'm doing work from home in Cilacap. So I have been in Cilacap for 2 months since the work from policy was conducted. I joined Rumah Produktif Indonesia to improve my ability for my relationship and gather with positive tips with great people just like you all. And I think that's all from me. Sorry.
Thank you, Mbak Anna.
Okay, you're welcome.
Thank you, Mbak Anna. Thank you very much. So, is there any question for Mbak Anna? Maybe you can ask Mbak Anna for the old member.
Maybe not. No question.
Who wants to ask a question? Anyone?
No, it's gone. Just gone.
I have a question to Mbak Anna. She's from Central Java. No.
Nothing, miss. Just go on with the next speaker, with the next self-introduction.
Okay, it's nice to meet you too, Ibu Rudriana Melisa. Please to meet you. It's nice to meet you today.
Okay, nice to meet you too, Miss Maulina Anwar.
Okay, nice to meet you.
Hello.
Yeah, hi.
Yeah. Okay, so because no one asked some questions, Muhammad Agus Nur from Bulukumba, South Sulawesi. So, Mr. Agus, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Hello. Okay.
Mr. Agus, the floor is yours. Hello.
Okay. Thank you very much for giving me chance for introduce my name. My name is Muhammad Agus Nur. This is my face. I live in Bulukumba. I'm with Miss Widya Rizky Pratiwi, and here Miss Widya invite me to join Rumah Produktif Indonesia, okay. I think this event is so nice because we can meet from the other area.
Apple to 8.
And my activity, now I'm a teacher. I'm a teacher in one of senior high school in Bulukumba. As usual, my activity is teaching, but because of lockdown, we are now work from home. I think that's all for me. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Agus. Actually, Mr. Agus.
Hello.
There, Agus. Last night. Well, can you hear me, Mr. Agus?
Yes.
Okay. The last night when she saw your face on pamphlet, she said that Mr. Agus is my teacher. Okay. Guys, for all the members, do you have any questions for Mr. Agus?
Thank you, Ms. Lydia.
No one? this afternoon is still silence.
Anyone want to ask some question?
Can I please? Can I? Yes. Your name? Yes. Do you invite me?
Yes, please. Kavidia want to ask us some question?
Oh yeah, thank you, because the signal is bad.
Okay.
Just simple question. Maybe I want to ask why you interest to join Rumah Kampung Indonesia, especially Rumah Kampung Indonesia and this world. And what do you think about this activity?
Okay. I think this activity is good, like meeting in the real time, in the real, I mean, not in online. Because of lockdown, so we have to make a creative policy, like we can meet in the daring. And then I think this is good. We can practice our English. And then we can meet a new friend. Hello?
Kavidia?
Yes? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Agus, answer this question.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Agus.
Thank you, Ms. Kavidia. Thank you.
So, for the last, not the last, but we still waiting for Mr. Ajat. Mr. Ajat is here. Oh, I think Mr. Ajat will come late. So, for next, Malina Anwar to introduce herself.
Okay, I'm here.
Malina, can you hear me?
Is yours? Yes, I can. Okay, thank you very much. I am Olina. Hi, everyone. I am from Kendari. Yes, I'm here in Kendari. I'm a student now. Thank you.
Any question?
To Ibu. Back to Musdalifa.
Yes.
Hi. Could you
introduce yourself, Kak Maulina?
Yes, I am Maulina. I am from Kendari in Southeast Sulawesi. I'm a student. I study from home, and I do activities from home. It's almost three months now. I want to study or learn something from this meeting. I want to know what is actually RPI, or what's actually, what is this, RPI? I'm curious to know and to see you talking about that.
That's all?
Yes, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Maulina, please.
Yeah, that's enough. That's enough from me. I'm shy to talk.
But you're great. Okay, anyone?
May I ask
some question?
Because no one. No one asked something. So.
Okay. Yes, please.
You speak English fluently, I think. You are newcomer here, and I'm really thanks because you joined with our meeting today. But I hear that you can speak English well and you can speak English fluently. So could you please share to us about the way you learn English or you started to learn English?
Okay, thank you. I learn English by myself at home. Listening to music, watching the movies. Today I watched two movies already. The title is Killers Among Us, and then one more. I forgot the movies. Actually, I always watch movies 2 times a day, and the movies are about the Western movies, and I learned the vocabularies, pronunciations, dialects, idioms from that movies, and also I try to connect with the people around, some people around Australia, Brazil, somewhere. So I try to connect with them and talk with them, chatting and so on. And I talk to my bestie, Bavidia, in English, and also to Mbak Mustalifa. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes. Kak Widya dan
thank you Kamalina for the lessons we addressed to Mr. Ajat. Sorry, Mr. Ajat, I can't hear you. I can't see you.
Yes, I am here.
You have a different name. Okay, Mr. Ajat, the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Ajat. People call me Ajat. Ajat Al-Ghafifi is my pen name. I was born 30 years ago in Jakarta. I am a home to British doctor. My daily activity as a teacher. I am a Arabic teacher in Islamic elementary school of Al Haraki Depok. I have many hobbies. Book, watching movie, design graphics, and video editing. I also like traveling and culinary trip. I can join with RPI English class, yeah, because I know my best. I hope I can develop my speaking English as well as possible. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, Mr. Ajat. So, for the old members, I invite you to ask some questions.
Yeah, this afternoon is too silent, and then I don't know why the signal is not really supported well.
Can I ask one question to Mr. Ajat?
Yes, please.
Yeah,
come on.
I like culinary too. And I am now learning English, actually not English, Chinese and Arabic. And I like when you say you are the teacher of Arabic. How long have you been teaching Arabic?
Mr. Rajat, can you hear me? It's
probably something happened with the signal.
Hello? Yes, with the signal, yeah. Mr. Rajat, can you hear me? Oh, where is Mr.
Okay, maybe he can answer later.
Rajat.
And I like culinary, that's why I asked the question.
Yeah.
I like eating.
I will say the question.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all. Now we go to the next section, and then we will talk about COVID-19 in health reviews. So our first speaker comes from at Rumah Sakit Islam Jakarta. Mr. Iskandar, can you hear me?
Yes, very clear. Thank you very much.
Okay. Okay. Mr. Iskandar, present your materials.
Yes. I started right now. Okay. Where is the signal?
Yes, please.
Yes.
Really sorry for that.
Yeah. Langsung mulai saya ya. Halo. Tuh suaranya Mbak ini putus juga ya, putus-putus ya.
Yes, please.
Ya. Yeah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Sometimes.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ya, baik langsung saya mulai aja ya. Halo, ya?
Iya.
Ya, baik. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Malik yaumiddin. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladzina an'amta 'alaihim. Ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim waladdallin amin. Faqad qala Allahu ta'ala fi kitabihil karim wa huwa asdaqul qailin wa ma asabakum min musibatin fabima kasabat aydikum wa ya'fu 'an katsir. Surah Asy-Syu'ara al-ayah 3. Ma'asyiral muslimin rahimakumullah. Yang berbahagia, baiklah saya akan coba ya to speak things about what happened in this world right now, which is called the spreading of the deadly contagious disease, which is called the COVID-19. So in this session, actually this is my bad, actually, ya, salah saya. I haven't prepared PPTs well, but I have sent you the group to the group of this English session about things that I want to say. Maybe you can read my journal on pictures that I've sent you in the WhatsApp group. So today, I want to talk about the viral disease. As we know that this disease has infected more than 5.1 million people around the world, 5,1 juta ya. Total of them is 2 million has recovered from their ill, and more than 300,000 ya, 333,000 people, yeah, dead. They are die just because of this virus, this coronavirus. So I would like to read about my journal here. Maybe you can catch my figures on the WhatsApp group. Okay, I'll read it for about 10 minutes. Maybe you can read all the abstract. The coronaviruses are a group of enveloped viruses with non-segmented, single-stranded, and positive sense RNA genomes. Ya, jadi ini tentang RNA ya. Dia bukan DNA, tapi RNA. RNA itu adalah re-oxybonucleic acid ya. Kalau DNA ada deoxyribonucleic acid. Jadi beda RNA dengan DNA, kalau DNA itu adalah deoxy ribonukleat acid, RNA adalah ribonukleat acid. Jadi ada perbedaan satu, kekurangan satu oksigen, namanya deoksi ya, mungkin bisa dilihat juga di gambar, deoksi ribonukleat acid. DNA ini yang ada di dalam tubuh manusia, dan RNA ini biasanya ada pada virus ya, termasuk virus corona ini. Dia adalah ribonukleat. Nah, dia kalau saudara tahu ribo itu adalah ribosom. Mungkin pernah belajar biologi dan kimia, ribosom itu adalah rantai glukosa atau dari gula dia sifatnya. Nukleat acid dan sifatnya adalah asam. Itu adalah materi genetik ya, yang membawa jutaan atau bahkan ribuan makhluk melata di muka bumi ini. So this coronavirus is this is the new one because this is the mutation of the previous corona that we found in 2003, and before that we have seen a coronavirus on the microscope in 1960 ya, 1960 kita mempunyai mikroskop elektron, dan dari situ kita bisa mengintip si corona ini gitu. Nah, novel coronavirus ini jadi it's emerged in Wuhan ya, timbul di Wuhan sekitar akhir tahun 2019, at the end of the 2019. And in January aja, itu yang pertama kali ya, belum nyampe ke Indonesia ya, di China itu ada 800 kasus dilaporkan ya. 800 cases fine. The coronavirus had large of family virus ya. Jadi saudara harus tahu bahwa corona ini tidak hanya menginfeksi manusia ya. They also infect birds ya, birds, burung, mammals, mamalia. Jadi monyet, kucing ya, anjing ya, hewan peliharaan itu juga bisa terinfeksi oleh corona. Jadi waspada yang punya kucing di rumah ya, yang punya hewan-hewan peliharaan, pets ya, bahwa mereka bisa menularkan virus corona. Dan ini yang ngomong WHO sendiri ya, Al-Munazzamah Sihatul Alam, World Health Organization, the human ya. These viruses has been responsible for several outbreaks around the world ya. Jadi virus ini udah membuat SARS ya tahun 2003 ya, dan juga virus ini bikin juga MERS juga ya, Middle East Respiratory Syndromes ya, di Korea Selatan tahun 2015. Jadi kalau saudara ya, ya melihat ya, if you saw the Bill Gates study ya, Bill Gates presentation in 2015 ya, itu memang ya di si Bill Gates ini dia udah tahu nih bakal jadi outbreak, dia akan bermutasi terus ini si virus ini. Jadi tahun 2015 sudah ditemukan di Korea Selatan. Nah, sekarang ini strain baru ya, jadi dia lebih kuat, more powerful, more strengthful ya, and then infected in the world in December 2019 ya, 2019 bulan Desember itu. Nah, but if you see the figure, the life cycle of coronavirus ya, jadi virus ini they enter our body ya, throughout the saliva, jadi lewat percikan ludah ya, droplet ya, dari orang yang terkena itu dalam radius 1 meter ya, they float ya, mereka melayang gitu, dan itu masuk ke kulit kita, apa, menempel di kulit ya, attach to our skin, and then get into our mouth, and then get into our lung. So that is the journey of this disease. Yeah, and when this virus get into our lung ya, jadi yang serang itu adalah lung ya, paru-paru ya, dia tidak menyerang organ lain karena paru-paru itu tempatnya nyaman buat dia untuk dibantai habis, lalu kemudian mereka replicated ya, bereplikasi sampai sel-sel paru-paru kita, parenkim paru kita tuh hancur semua karena diambilin DNA-nya, diambilin untuk bikin RNA anak-anak cucu mereka begitu. Pertama dia adalah attach dan entry ya, then replicate protein expression, then the third replication of and transcription, and the fourth is assembly and release. Jadi istilahnya dia ya nempel, lalu kemudian dia penetrasi ke dalam inti sel, dan inti sel tersebut dirusak DNA-nya, diambil materinya, dan sel tersebut tinggalkan dalam keadaan mati ya, and then they replicate, replikasi sampai triliunan viruses. Nah, the Director General of the WHO ya, resiko dari penyakit ini ternyata fatal disease ya, mengakibatkan kematian only 2%. Ya, jadi only 2%. Sisanya ya, kayak misalkan kita temukan Pak Budi Karya Sumadi ya, di Ministry of Transportation ya, it's one of that 80% ya, adalah satu dari 80 orang yang survive ya. Dan kita 14%-nya lagi menyerang lansia ya. Menyerang lansia, orang-orang tua ya, di elderly people ya. Terus bikin juga gagal ginjal, gagal jantung sekitar 5% ya, more than 5% they make the renal and the heart failure. So what are the symptoms? Apa gejala-gejalanya ya? Gejala-gejalanya ya gejala pilek ya. Sneezing ya, haji, bangkis ya. Running nose ya, hidung meler, cough ya. Tadi ada yang batuk juga tuh, barangkali harus waspada ya. Cough ya. Kalau di Amerika itu COVID. Itu diplesetkan menjadi COVID, udah dibatukin aja, dikeluarkan gitu maksudnya. Si virusnya. Dan ternyata dia juga mengakibatkan gejala di saluran cerna juga ya, di gastrointestinal, symptoms ya, they can cause diarrhea ya. Saya bikin mencret. Jadi kalau ada mencret ya, bukan berarti dia itu kena apa sih, makanan jorok atau bagaimana ya. Bisa jadi ini gejala dari si COVID ini yang sudah entering ya, memasuki fase pembuangan tubuh kita lewat GI tract ya, gastrointestinal tract, lewat usus. Terus ada lagi sore throat ya, gejalanya sore throat, sakit tenggorokan ya, tenggorokan gatal, nggak enak nih rasanya, waktu harus waspada. And then di exacerbated asthma, pada beberapa orang bikin asma ya, sesak ya, bangkitan asma, pada orang yang asma lalu kemudian dia mengakibatkan bangkitan asma pada saat si COVID ini dia replicate. So what can we do in this situation ya, kira-kira apa yang bisa kita lakukan nih kalau sudah ada gejala ini ya, selain call the doctor ya, get into the hospital, get the medical exam ya, di doing the rapid test ya, to get the rapid test. You can resting and avoiding overexertion. Jadi ya, harus istirahat ya, resting. Nggak boleh keluar rumah, ya udah di kasur aja gitu, bed rest ya. Kayak orang malas lah gitu. Drinking enough water ya, harus banyak minum ya supaya mencegah dehidrasi ya. To avoid dehydrating and avoiding smoking ya. Ada orang bilang ini rokok membunuh ya. Smoking kills corona. Itu salah besar ya. Kita harus avoiding smoking ya, dan end smoky area because of fact ya, karena rokok itu dia merusak paru-paru. Jadi paru-paru udah dirusak sama si virus ya, broken by the virus, and then you get more damage with smoking ya, bikin lagi tambah rusak paru-paru Anda ya. Itu jangan sampai merokok. Taking the acetaminophen ya, kalau panas ya minum paracetamol ya, ibuprofen ya, obat demam. Terus harus punya namanya a clean humidifier ya, atau vaporizer. Jadi udaranya kalau bisa lembab ya, harus pakai pelembab udaranya. Dan juga use the hand sanitizer. The transmission ya, transmission of the viruses itu lewat fluid ya, lewat cairan in the respiratory system, di sistem saluran nafas seperti mukus ya. Mukus itu jadi bagian dalam dari mulut ya, seperti buka ya, masuk ke dalam lagi ke bawah, itu ada paru-paru bagian dalam itu, ada rongga tenggorokannya itu yang merah-merah itu, dia lewat situ. Jadi kalau transmisinya harus diperhatikan ya, jangan sampai kena. Coronavirus can spread in the following ways ya, kira-kira corona itu bisa menyebar melalui cara cough ya, batuk, sneeze, ya, bersin without covering the mouth, ya, tanpa menutup mulut tuh. Jadi yang batuk-batuk itu nggak mau nutup mulutnya ya, pakai lengan dalam, nah itu harus diwaspadai dia mau menularkan penyakit. Ya. Touching, shaking hands with person who has the virus can pass the virus between individual ya. Jadi nggak usah lah salam-salaman dulu ya. Kalau bisa itu dihindarkan kontak tangan. Some animal coronavirus, such as felin coronavirus, may spread to contact with feces. Jadi felin ini adalah Felix ya, Felix the cat ya. Itu kucing itu ternyata kotorannya ya, tai kucingnya yang suka di pinggir jalan itu ya, tiba-tiba ada bau tidak enak ya, itu bisa menularkan virus corona. Jadi kalau ada tai kucing ya, kalau bisa kita rumah kita dibersihkan dan dibersihkan juga itu kandangnya. Nah, ada tiga orang ya. There is three kind of person ya yeah, that really affected with this virus. Ada tiga orang yang sangat rentan satu.
Mr. Iskandar, can you show your face?
Kurang ya suaranya ya. Halo. Aduh, Mbak juga nggak kedengeran sama saya suaranya ini.
Hello, your face. Is it okay?
Oh, face. Because I don't have laptop, so I read it from my phone. So I'm sorry. Maybe after reading this journal, you may see my face. Because I don't have another laptop. Okay. Yeah. I'm sorry for this situation. Yeah. I ask you for five minutes again. Then you will have my voice. You will have my face. Yes. Ya, grup yang tiga orang ini yang sangat rentan ya, ya terhadap penyebaran virus ya. These are the person that we must protect. First, the young children ya. Anak-anak itu jangan sampai terkontak ya. Kita lihat jalanan itu sama anak-anak ya. Dan namanya main petasan segala macam itu didiemin saja sama orang tuanya begitu ya. Nah, itu yang membuat sekarang parah ya. Sampai dua kali lipat itu. We got this people infected twice in 3 days before. And the second people age 65 years or older. Jadi umur 65 tahun lebih itu yang bikin, itu yang harus kita lindungi. Ya, anak-anak umur 65 tahun dan yang ketiga adalah wanita hamil ya. Woman with pregnancy. So, in the end of my session here, I would like to give you more update. With last day, we got more than 900 people infected by the coronavirus. New case finding, ya, 900 orang lebih itu terinfeksi kemarin. Padahal kemarin lusanya itu baru 500-an ya, so only 500. If you see my photos right here, and then what can we do about this? The Bill Gates and Melinda Foundation now has raised the CureVac. Ya, sudah menerbitkan CureVac ya. Release CureVac itu katanya bisa mencegah penyebaran dari corona ini. Jadi ada orang yang suzon sama beliau, have a negative thinking to the Bill Gates and the Melinda. They think that Bill Gates sell vaccine by spreading the coronavirus first. So, wallahu alam, I thought this is a very, very evil mind. Yeah. And then the chloroquine 150 milligram is prescribed to the patient in the outlet hospital in Jakarta. They should take this medication, the chloroquine 150 milligram twice daily. Yeah. And then they also injected by vitamins to cover their body. And then the coronavirus data. Today we got 5.1 until 5.2 million infected with corona. And total death is more than 335 person day death. Just by today. So what can we do? We can do prayer. As Allah said, wa ma asabakum min musibatin fa bima kasabat aydikum wa ya'fu an katsir. Apa saja musibah yang menimpa kamu, maka disebabkan oleh perbuatan tanganmu sendiri. Okay, all the misery that come to you is made by your own hand. And Allah give you forgiveness. And Allah memaafkan sebagian kamu, ya. Asy-Syu'ara, Syura ayat 30. Saya pikir demikian ya yang bisa saya sampaikan. Mungkin saudara-saudara akan melihat wajah saya lagi karena saya tadi baru saja membuka HP saya. Sekarang saya mau tutup lagi dan kembali bersama teman-teman. Oke. Okay. I think that is what I can say to you and we can have discussion after this.
Okay, yeah. That's all by Mr. Iskandar. Thank you very
much. Yes, thank you very much. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Okay, thank you Mr. Iskandar. So I'm going to the second speakers for this morning. I invite Ms. Rati Arum Listiandini from Clinic Student, and then from now she's a PhD student at University of South Wales, Australia. Ms. Rati, can you hear my voice? Bu Rati Arum Listiandini, can you hear my voice? Oh, maybe something happened with the signal. So, Mr. Rati can hear my voice.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
Hello? Bu Rati?
Can you hear me?
Can you present your materials? Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, great. Thank you. Okay, actually, I already sent the materials to Mbak Wiwit. Okay, so Mbak Wiwit will help me to present with the slide. Actually, I already prepared small information for you.
Yes.
Yeah. So I would like to share today about how to deal psychologically with the COVID-19. Yeah. Maybe Dr. Iskandar already explained to us about the condition right now is quite difficult for us related to this pandemic. So that's why we really need to handle the psychological and the social well-being effect of this COVID-19. And in this presentation, I would like to discuss about the importance of the psychological resilience. What is it? You will also see that in this presentation. Okay, before I start to present my slide, maybe I would like to introduce myself first. My name is Rati Arum. You can call me Mbak Rati, Mbak Arum, Bu Rati, Bu Arum, it's up to you. And I'm now working as a clinical psychologist and lecturer at the URC University Jakarta. But I'm also study at UNSW Sydney right now as a PhD student in here, in the Sydney. So let me start the discussion. Okay. Yeah.
Wow.
Okay. Bawit, can you help me to present again the slide? Hello?
Maybe because of the Bu Rati, so there will be a little bit a distraction. So really sorry
for
that.
That's okay. Hello.
Okay. Yes. Bu Rati, we can hear your voice. So you are in Australia right now.
The slide right now. Can you help me to scroll down the PDF? Yeah.
Okay.
It's still loading, I think. Scroll down the PDF. Go to the next slide.
Yeah, it's still. Maybe because of the signal, so a little bit slow.
The signal is
Yeah, maybe you while waiting for Kak Widya, maybe Bu Rati can say
hello. Okay, Okay, actually,
so
if not, maybe
what time
I will,
in
yeah.
Australia right now?
If not, maybe I will try to present with my slide. Is it possible? But maybe we should close the share screen first. I will try to open with my PC in here.
Yes, it's
maybe the signal in here is quite good, so I can share it to you. Okay, I will try to present from my. Okay. Let me see.
Maybe we can read the slide on a group, and then we want to see Bu Ratih Tarum.
Okay.
Face.
Let me see.
Okay, so for all the members, can you hear our voice?
Let me try. Okay.
Certificate of our weekly meeting today. You can contact.
Sorry, can you see the slide?
For the presenter who prepared the presentation.
Hello.
Okay, Bu Ratih, is it okay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Can you see the slide?
Yeah.
Right now? Okay. Not yet.
No.
Hello.
We can see the slide.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes.
Can you see the slide?
We can see the slide, Bu Ratih.
You can
no,
see?
No, we can.
No, I can't. Okay. I can't see the slide.
You cannot see?
No, we can't.
You cannot see the slide?
Yes, we can. We cannot.
Okay,
cannot
let me see.
Yes,
maybe
see
I choose the wrong one. This one is okay. I already choose the entire
there
screen.
Is
hello. Let me see.
Please end now at.
How about this one? Not yet.
No, really. Oh, wait.
I see.
On
maybe
process.
You can guide me, like.
Wait a minute.
I'm really
Bu
familiar
Ratih,
with this.
Waiting.
Yeah.
Okay,
sorry.
Anyone?
Actually, I already tried to click the presenting
the
in here, but I don't know which one. I don't know how to choose the. Maybe I will stop this course.
Ratih, please press.
I will help you, Ms. Ratih.
Press the what is that?
I will help you.
The present now.
Is it now then?
Yeah.
Okay, continue, Ms. Ratih.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, can you go to the second slide? Not this one. This one is the last slide. Sorry. Yeah. Next. Can you scroll down a little bit?
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, this one. This one is the second slide.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, what I would like to say right now is maybe you can feel anything right now. You can feel bored because of the social distancing. You can also feel maybe sad or maybe worries or maybe anxious, or you just get panic. Maybe not panic again, but right now is maybe there is also a kind of like an angry with the condition, because maybe in Indonesia it seems like this pandemic is uncontrollable. So it seems like many of us feels angry with the other people who cannot follow the rule of the restriction, or maybe with the government who maybe not good enough to handle these cases. But everything that you feel right now is actually something that may be quite common in this condition, and that's why we call this as a condition of the stress condition during the panic during the pandemic condition. Okay, next slide. Okay, actually during the pandemic situation, all of these are the common feelings, And this is the common feelings during the uncommon situation, because this is unusual situation. Maybe this is like a very new situation for you. And it is like a very natural and very normal if you feel maybe like bored or maybe like anxious, or could be maybe also like the worry about the future, about this uncertainty condition. Next slide. So what I'm going to discuss today is about why we feel in this way, like how we feel like bored, anxious, or angry, and how to cope with this situation. Next. Okay, why do I feel this way? Why do you feel? How us as a community feel this kind of feeling? Actually, it is part of our human response when we perceive situation as a stress. Maybe you already quite familiar with the term of the stress, but what is stress exactly? So next slide. I'm going to explain about this one first. Yeah, actually, during the stress life events like a pandemic right now, we should adjust many things, including the changes, and maybe in the future until we find the vaccine. Maybe about 1.5 until 2 years later, we should adjust with this new normal condition. So during this condition, it is very common for us to feel maybe for the first time is the condition such as shock, or maybe like a denial, or maybe like a frustration, or maybe something such as like depression. But hopefully that after the time already always ongoing in the future, we can find another way to cope with this situation, to handle with this new normal situation. You can try many things that help you to adjust with the condition, and in this regard, until we have like an integration with the new situation into our normal daily life. So it is very common, like in the beginning of the process, we should process all this psychological condition. But hopefully then if we know how to handle the psychological effects of this pandemic, then we can in the future have like a better adjustment with this stress life events like a pandemic right now. Okay, next. Yeah, actually, what is stress? If we can say that right now the COVID itself is like such a pressure or demand from the environment, and this demand outside our capacity. So that's why we feel stressed about something. So if you say that you feel stressed about the situation, it means like maybe the situation is maybe very new to you, and you don't have any previous experience how to handle with this problem. Okay, next slide. Okay, yeah. And during the stress response, we can choose actually, or this is like the quiet common response during we feel stress. We can fight. So our response such as like angry, or maybe we blaming about the situation, it's part of the our fight condition. But we can also doing like a flight condition. Flight, it's mean like we don't want to cope with the situation with the new normal, so we just like deny, we just like ignore the situation. So that's also part of the stress condition also. And another thing is maybe we can feel also the freeze situation. The freeze condition is when we feel hopeless, we don't know how to handle with the situation. It seems like there's no hope during the future, so that's the freeze situation. And I think everyone has their own response to this distress condition. Maybe you can have like a fight or flight, or just like a freeze. So it really depends on people to people, and every person has their own response. Next. So this is the typical situation that triggered the stress itself. Maybe the uncertainty itself during this pandemic is creating a kind of the distress, and another one is also maybe the social distancing itself, because we actually as a human being need frequent contact with other people. So with the physical distancing and the social distancing right now that happen in our life, so it can trigger any distress in us. And another one is also maybe the unverified rumors or the concern about the possibility of being infected, because right now, for example, like in Indonesia, the cases is so high and the fatal rate is also high. So maybe we also concerned about the possibility of being infected. And maybe another thing is like us, maybe we feel unavailable also to control other people's action. So it is we feel maybe angry about the situation and we don't know how to handle with the stressful life condition during this crisis. Next slide. Next slide. Okay. So right now is how to cope with this situation. Actually, I prepare some strategies to handle with this situation. If you feel angry, maybe you feel worried, or maybe you feel bored about the condition, what should we do? Next slide. Yeah, this is what we need today, is the resilience. So the resilience itself is something that we call as an ability to bounce back, to thrive, to be able to follow, or to be able to thrive, bounce back, or to wake up again from the difficult situation. So like a ball, if we feel down, then we can go to the normal condition. This we call as a resilience. So if in the terms of the psychological resilience, what I mean is like we should have an ability to bring our life to go back such in the good condition. In this regard is we should go back from the condition of the angry, or from the condition of the worries or the depression itself. Next. So during this situation, what you should focus on is the things that matter to you and the things you can control. We cannot control our government, we cannot control other people's, but we can control ourselves, we can control our response. So that's why what you should focus on during this situation, because if we want to control everything, we cannot do that. We can still share about the tips how to prevent the COVID, but we cannot control everyone's response. So during the situation, what we really need to is focusing on the things that you can control and focusing on the things that matter to you right now. Next slide. Okay, this is the tips that I would like to share to you, how to focus in on the energy on what you can control. The first one is being aware. The second is being care. In here is care about yourself and care about others, at least the family member around you, being smart, being connected, and also being spiritual. Okay, next slide. What I mean with the being aware is in here, I call it like mindfulness. Mindful means like you are aware in the present moment. So not worry about the future, but you focus your energy about the positive activity that you can do right now. So, and sometimes it is okay to not feel okay. In this regard, if you feel sad, that's okay. Maybe you need time to process that feeling, or maybe you feel angry about the situation because you cannot do anything to change it, that's also okay. Just let the feeling on yourself as fully as in the present moment, and you will realize that the negative feeling usually will also pass by the time. And you can also try to do the mindful breathing. So if you feel anxious, worried, or angry, just focusing on your breathing. If you focus on your breath, then it will release your tension. And maybe if you want, you can also try to the mindfulness meditation. You can search the tutorial maybe in the YouTube about how to do mindfulness meditation itself. Next. And keep caring yourself by doing like a healthy lifestyle, the nutrition, sleep, and then physical exercise, the hygiene. It is very important for us to keep our hygiene, wash your hand frequently, and care about the cleanliness of your home. And find also the good coping strategies for you. For example, if you have certain feeling, maybe you can explain that feeling in the journal, or maybe you can have like the spiritual coping, or doing the relaxation, or maybe just give the positive affirmation to yourself, so that you have like a more positive energy to follow your day. And another one that should be maintained is also our daily activities. So even you are working at home or study at home, if possible, if create the regular and routine activities in every day, so you still have an energy and still have like a productivity in your everyday setting. And of course, you should spare at least one activity that makes you happy. It could be hobby, or you can learn new skills. So I think the English school like this is very important. Maybe for you in here, because we can learn something new in here. We can learn how to speak English, and maybe you can also learn the new topics every week. That's a good strategy for us, like to keep our mind healthy. Next slide. Okay. Being smart in here is to filter the information. So if you realize that maybe you are quite anxious people, don't access the COVID information all day long. Filter the information and choose wisely the resource of the and the references of the information that you digest every day. And try to thinking in a realistic way. And if the problem still exists, for example, like if there is like a specific impact of this pandemic to your economic or financial condition, for example, you should do the problem solving. What should we can do to handle the situation itself? Next slide. And be still being connected. So keep socializing. In here is maybe because of the physical distancing, you can still socializing using the social media, using the WhatsApp, for example, or maybe doing like the video conference like this. And if you feel some kind of the negative feelings, you can try to self-disclose about what you feel right now. And if it is possible, you can seek for help. In Indonesia itself, there are also plenty of organization and the psychological organization that can help you with the free online counseling. You can access that support if you need to talk to someone. Next. And cherish every moment. So you can try to figure out about what is the good thing that still happen in your life every day. And you can create a kind such as the gratitude jar like this. You can write down what is the positive things that still ongoing on your life. Maybe you still have family. You can have like a good food for today. You can write down on the journal or put it on the small papers and put it on the jar like this. And this with this way, we can feel that we appreciate and thanks for what you already and still have in life, which is from God or from others. And if we feel more gratitude, more grateful about our life, then it will bring more positive emotion to our everyday life, and it will reduce, hopefully, the negative feelings that we have. Next. Okay, and finding the meaning and purpose. How? by keep contributing in this regard is giving something meaningful to the world, or you can find what is the most important thing in your life. Maybe you can learn the new skill if you really love to learn something new, or you can also go to the have a donation if you feel that it will help people. It's really important for our well-being too. And keep developing yourself, developing your personal strength, your attitude, and learning new skills from home. Next. Okay, so it is important for us to have the growth mindset. So keep learning, keep going, and look for the lessons from this COVID, and hopefully we can grow even we have facing difficulties like this right now. Next. Okay, this is the end my presentation. So accept what it is, let go of what was, and have faith for what will be. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the presenter, for the speakers today. Thank you, Bu Rati, Mbak Arum. Yes. Thank you very much for the nice presentation. Really sorry about my background, because in Makassar, we will prepare for take asap pray. So maybe maybe some of you will listen, because my house is nearby the mosque. So really sorry for that. Okay, so before we come to the question and answer, so Pak Iskandar will leave. Okay, thank you, Pak Iskandar. So some of the members prepare their question, but I want to ask question for Bu Rati, because this is actually my personal question. Is it okay, Bu Rati?
Okay.
Okay, well, as we can see right now in Makassar especially, it seems like the people are not afraid anymore, because they go everywhere without any distraction about COVID-19. They really don't care anymore about that. Don't you think that the people is not feeling panic anymore? Because I can see in Jakarta too, on the airport, there are many people out there. So what do you think about this situation in psychology reviews? Thank you.
Okay, thank you for your question. Yeah, actually, if you see from the from the curve that I shared before, yeah. Actually, people maybe in some extent, maybe they could be deny the situation or ignore the situation, or they don't just still a very the ignorance condition could be triggered by two factors. It could be they stress, but they ignore the situation, so they don't want to think about it, so they just do what they want to do. Or the second one is because they already feel that it is too long for them to handle the situation, so they doing something that something that can trigger the COVID spreading condition. Maybe also because they don't have any enough information, maybe not enough information, but maybe the policy in the government itself maybe also influence the Indonesian's psychological condition. I saw this is from more the social psychological perspective, but what I saw is people need strict regulation if they want to have the normal life without the strict regulation. If the authorities cannot handle the strict regulation, then people will violate, because they don't know, or maybe they don't just realize that every single action that we have right now have a effect to the other people. So it could be many factors, and we should we couldn't explain it only by one factors. So maybe the case from one to another people could be different, and I think we need more research about that. But from what I see is the regulation itself, and then the policy, or maybe the long-term condition that cannot be handled by other peoples. Many things that could affect with the situation right now. Or maybe people also see, maybe because they are too selfish with themselves, so they don't have any empathy, for example, it could be also a kind of the, like a trigger for that kind of situation. So they don't think from the other's perspective. They only think about what they feel happy to do. They don't think that their action can be have like negative effects for the community. Maybe that could be also the problem. So we should see maybe so many factors. So that's why maybe we need to do more research and study on that questions. That's very good question, actually, the intriguing questions to have like a further discussion. Thank you for asking about that.
Thank you very much, Bu Rati. So I invite the participant. Maybe some of you want to ask some question to Bu Rati. Please give your comment, or anyone want to ask some question to both of our speakers today? Kak Maulina, maybe you want to ask some question?
Okay. It's not a question. Actually, it's a kind of activity that I like to. I did, and today I don't do it because I feel like I'm boring to do that. The kind of a mindfulness meditation, I call it yoga from home. So I used to have yoga. It's almost 2 months doing the same activity in the morning, but then I can finally realize that this is a kind of a boring activity to minimize the anxiety, the fear and the stressful in my mind, and I kind of looking for another kind of activity to make me feel like I fulfill all the day with the productive activity instead of watching the Western movie or listening to music or reading or join the meeting. So I don't know what kind of other activities which is active or positive for me other than doing the yoga, because today I stopped doing the yoga, and probably from the psychologist's views, you can give me something like, oh, you can do this, because I'm now stuck with the, you know, these things. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Okay. I think that's the problem for everyone. Like, we already bored to do the same thing every day. So, but that's okay. Maybe you already feel bored about the yoga, but you can still find maybe another exercise. You can try maybe aerobic, or maybe you can try the Zumba. Just try to manage as many as activities that you think that you can still do at home. Even if you just like doing like a writing, journaling, or maybe reading new books, for examples, it could be also like an option. But that's okay. In some extent, we still find each of us maybe feel bored. And I think that's the normal reaction. So if you feel bored, don't push to yourself to not feel bored.
Yes, today, what I mean today is I feel
just,
that.
Yes. Just accept the boring condition. But okay, I feel bored. I don't know what to do. Okay, that's fine. Because maybe we cannot have like a very... It is quite impossible for us have like a 24 hours happy feeling every time. So it's okay to feel bored, but as long as you can find any new activities that you think might help you and explore as many as possible, that's still very good for your psychological condition. That's my remark for you.
Yeah, thank you very much. That's why I feel like I lose my weight. It's I was 53 1 month ago, and today I got 48.
Okay. Imagine.
Wow.
It's a kind of a diet too because Ramadan day. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much. I've tried to find.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I love the quotes from Murati. Is it okay? Not feeling okay? That's very awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, for all the members, anyone want to ask some question? Pak Iskandar still is here? Well, actually, I have a private question for Pak Iskandar, but maybe she want to leave. For the other members, anyone want to ask or give comment or about our topic today? Mbak Anna, maybe want to say something?
Okay, Ms. Musdalifa, thank you. Yes. I just want to ask to Mr. Iskandar.
Okay.
Herd immunity. We often hear about herd immunity today. So how it's working? Is it really we need doing herd immunity?
Okay. Thank you, Mbak Anna. Mr. Iskandar, actually that is my question also. We are in the same boat, Mbak Anna. That's my question. Well, Pak Iskandar, hopefully you will answer our question because two person have the same question here. Mr. Iskandar, can you hear me? Oh, Pak Iskandar is not here.
Maybe he's unmute. Maybe remind him to.
Oh yeah. Pak Iskandar is still here.
Yes, okay. I'm still here.
Can you hear us, Pak Iskandar?
Yeah, I have a question about herd immunity.
Yes.
So the herd immunity actually is the term that used in the psychological area. Yeah. Maybe this is the Miss Rati Arum. Territory to explain about the herd immunity because we in the medical school, I graduated from ERC medical school in 2006, so there is no psychology property in that time, so I maybe not meet with Miss Rati. During my study in the 1999 until 2006, I never heard about the herd immunity. What I heard about immunity is the humoral immunity. I heard about the cellular immunity, but I got these terms lately. Yes, about this 1-2 months ago. Yeah, since the COVID-19 spread us. The herd immunity, from what I learned, this is about the things that we think that ourselves is in the best condition to fight this coronavirus disease. So the herd immunity is the feeling about things that you can fight this disease just by doing the what we so call the PHBS, yeah. The health behavior and the health healthy life that you perform in your activity of daily living. So what I'm trying to say to you is the herd immunity is about things that happen onto your life, yes, and you can feel it that you able to live and to get your health in the best condition. So the herd immunity, maybe we can find it in the situation that we have the good sanitation, the good hygiene, yes, always wash your hands, always check to the doctor if you get bad condition in the health situation, you can find it with your, or even if you can, if you cannot meet the doctor, there is applications that you can use to check your body for the temperatures, the blood pressure, the respiratory rate, and the heartbeat, which is you can find it the normal normal measurement. Are you in the in this normal measurement or not? So what I think the herd immunity is something that we need to put in our mind that we are healthy, we are strong. I'm not sick. Yeah, you just by saying that you are not sick, so you will be not a sick person. So in internal medicine that I have learned 10 years ago, that we have the branch of the internal medicine, which is so-called the psychosomatic. Psychosomatic, maybe Ms. Arumi know about this branch of knowledge, the psychosomatology, which is called how our mind can affect the illness of our body. How you can get sick just by thinking somebody that you hate. How you might be so happy just by thinking somebody that you love. So this is what is so-called the immuno-neuro-endocrinology. Immuno-neuro-humoro-endocrinology. Jadi ini adalah ilmu tentang imunologi, ya, humorus, tentang cairan tubuh, dan juga tentang neuroendokrinologi. Jadi tentang hormon, hormon releases to our body when we are feel not safe, when we are feel not happy. So this which is so called the endorphin hormones and spread into our body, which is give good effect. And there is so called the serotonin. Serotonin is the hormones that release from our endocrines that affect our affective, that affect our mood. So might be this herd immunity is related with these hormones. So by the doing the positive thinking, get yourself together with your God, maybe it can increase your herd immunity. So you can fight this situation and survive it. I think that's all I can say.
Okay, thank maybe you. Mbak Anna?
Mbak Anna? Maybe Ms. Arum can add it.
Yeah. Maybe Bu Arum want to say something or give a comment. Yeah, is it okay, Mbak Anna? We listen from a psychologist perspective.
Okay. Yeah, actually, I agree that our mindset will help us to handle our health condition also. So that's why it keeps important for us to keep our mind healthy. But even we keep our mind healthy, but doesn't mean we should ignore with the hygiene, or we should deny that we should keep our cleanliness in everyday life. So I think to have like a good herd immunity, you still should combine how to have a good psychological condition, plus you still do the preventive measures in terms of the health situation right now, like washing your hands and also keep your body also healthy and doing like the physical distancing, something like that. That's my opinion.
Okay, yeah. Thank you, Mbak Arum, Bu Arum, Bu Rati. Mbak Anna, are you satisfied with the answer of for two experts today?
Yes, I think, but maybe my question is, it is safe for us to spend our activity as usually, as long as we can pay attention with our health, with our clean and our health. Is that correct? By using this herd immunity.
Yes, herd immunity is about positive thinking about your health condition and do the steps and try to get more informed, well informed about this health and this disease throughout the internet and the online media. Also, the herd immunity is only known by that person, not by the others, even the doctor. Yes, that's it.
Because maybe Miss Aurum, it's really boring for me to see to meet other people by online, yeah. Because we are a human, we just like social.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I agree with you, but keep in mind that actually the preventive measures is still very important. So if you want to meet someone, just make sure that you have like the physical distancing at least 1.5 until 2 meters, and yes, keep body hygiene, something like that. So hopefully that if every one of us aware with this condition, that this is a very special condition, then we need to have like the new normal. So that's why the new normal, in my opinion, is we should have like the healthy lifestyle to survive during this crisis. And even if you want to meet someone, just make sure that it's not on the crowded place. If you just keep the physical distancing, anything related that can prevent the COVID should be done very carefully. That's my opinion.
Yeah. Yes, okay. Mana, is it?
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
For all the members, maybe you want to say comment, any comment about our topic today? Pak Majid and Mr. Hidayat. Mr. Hidayat goes to take a pray, asar pray, because, he say already. Anyone wants to say? Ask some question or any comment.
May I please?
Yes, Kak Widya, please.
Okay, thank you very much for the time that given to me. Maybe I miss some information because today I think the signal is bad. And then my question goes to Ibu Rati. Could you listen my voice?
Yes.
Okay, because as I know that you live in Australia now, so could you please share to us how the government of Australia handled this COVID-19 pandemic to the community,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
Lockdown or something like in Indonesia? Thank you.
Yeah, actually there's also lockdown condition, but the condition right now is going better. Why? Because the first thing is actually the Australian citizen is not as many as Indonesian citizen, so they can have, so the government have more control on the people. So in this regard, what I found is the government is really strict with the regime. Even during the lockdown before, if you sit on the parks, for example, you will be fined by the police, and the fines is very, very high. But the condition right now in Indonesia, we cannot have that kind of fine. Why? Maybe because not every people will be can pay the fine itself.
We're not fine, but we get pushed up.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know. But I think the regulation itself is can help reduce the number. Because besides the lockdown, Australia also closed the border from the citizen outside of the country, except their own citizen. For example, like if you have Australian citizen, you can still enter to Australia, but government will help you to quarantine yourself in such a facilitation from the government. But if you are Indonesian citizen, for example, and you want to come to Australia, you cannot do that again until this week, until today. So it will also reduce the number of the COVID cases. And another case is Australia have like a very excellent health service. That's That's the best part how this country handle, because like even you should go to the hospital, you can have the ventilator. And that's why the fatality rate in this country is very, very low, because the health service is also very good. But in Indonesia, we have like lack of facilities. So if you go to the hospital, maybe you cannot survive because you cannot have the ventilator. So that's why. So I think the condition in Indonesia right now is quite difficult. So what we can do, in my opinion, is save yourself, save your family, and do what you can do, because you cannot rely on the decision of the government, for example. You cannot rely on the people who maybe do not listen to the regulation. So it is very difficult in Indonesia. But what we can do right now is just keep yourself safe, and at least your family, and educate as many as possible of the person around you. If they don't listen, so it's up to them.
Up to you.
But at least you already educate about what should we do to prevent the spreading of the virus. That's my opinion.
Okay, thank you very much for the explanation, Bu Rati. Kak Widya, is it clear?
Yes, very clear. Okay. Thank you.
Well, actually, there will be some question more for Ba'an. I think it's not really quite difficult. Is it safe for now to go abroad? Is it right, Ba'ana?
Yes, is it safe for us?
Ba'ana maybe want to go somewhere, yeah?
I don't think it's safe to go abroad right now.
Ah, okay.
At least you can still maintain your social contact. If you really want to meet someone, then you can have a meeting, but keep in mind that you still have the physical distancing. But it's still very risky to have to go abroad, because you never know whether you are bring the virus or not, or maybe the people who met in the airport or people you met in the other country have the COVID virus, because there are so many asymptomatic cases from I know.
So stay home and stay positive thinking, yeah, Mbak Rati.
Yeah.
So anymore, I think our time is limited. So, anyone want to say a comment? I think no, yeah, because we have a limited time. So. Thank you for the both of our excellent speakers. Thank you very much, Bu Rati and Pak Iskandar. That's a really amazing topic, because we got many knowledge from that. So thank you very much. And also thank you for the participant who can attend in our weekly meeting today. So if you want to get your certificate, you can contact Kak Widya. So thank you very much for today. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. See you.
Thank you.